Let's do an example of limit laws using graphs. The directions here state that the graphs of f and g are given. Use them to evaluate each limit if it exists. If the limit does not exist, explain why. Okay, so we're given the graphs of two functions, f of x and g of x, and you can see those here. And then below, we have several limits that we're asked to find. So let's start with the first one. Okay, so in part A, we're asked to find the limit as x goes to 2 of f of x plus g of x. So let's use the limit laws we just learned to break this up. So this is the limit as x goes to 2 of f of x plus the limit as x goes to 2 of g of x. Okay, and then for those individual pieces, we simply have to look at the graphs to see what those equal. So the limit is x goes to 2 of f of x. Okay, so I want to look at my f of x graph, and I want to look at what's happening to the y values as x goes to 2. Okay, so let me draw some arrows to help remind you how to think about that. Okay, so I'm going to x equals 2, and what's my y value approaching? My y value is approaching 2 as well. Even though there's a hole there, the limit as x goes to 2 of f of x is still 2. Okay, and then same deal with g of x. Okay, so we want to know the limit as x goes to 2. All right, so I'm approaching 2. Okay, this function is nice and continuous, so it's just 0. Okay, so my final answer for this limit is 2. All right, let's move on to the next one. Okay, so the next one's very similar. It's also an addition problem. We're just going to a different x value. Okay, so once again, we want to split this up using our limit laws. So this is going to be the limit as x goes to 1 of f of x plus the limit as x goes to 1 of g of x. Okay, and once again, I want to look at my graphs to figure that out. Okay, so limit as x goes to 1 of f of x. So x equals 1, I'm approaching it, and my y value is approaching 1 there. And similarly for g of x. Okay, so g of x as x goes to 1. Okay, so this is a little different, right? Because I'm going from 1 to the left and now to 1 from the right. And what happens? The two sides don't match up. So remember, if the two sides don't match up, the limit to that number overall does not exist. Okay, so since the limit as x goes to 1 of g of x does not exist, this whole limit does not exist. So it does not exist because limit as x goes to 1 of g of x does not exist. Okay, so let's keep going. To give ourselves a little bit of room, I'm going to erase what we've done so far and then keep working on part C. Okay, so part C is a product. Okay, so it's the limit as x goes to 0 of the product of f of x and g of x. So remember, there's a limit rule for products as well. Basically, it's similar to addition. The limit of the product is the product of the limits. So I can write this as the limit as x goes to 0 of f of x times the limit as x goes to 0 of g of x. And then I just have to decide what each of those limits are. Okay, so let's look at the picture. So the limit is x goes to 0 of f of x. So x is going to 0. And I see that the function is also going to 0. 0 times and then g of x as x goes to 0. Well, it's 1 point something, but it doesn't really matter, right? Because I'm multiplying by 0 anyway. I'll say times 1.4, but my final answer is just going to be 0. Okay, so the limit of that product is 0. Okay, so let's keep going. Next, we have the limit of a quotient. So once again, there's a rule for limit of quotients also. And that rule is the limit of the quotient is the quotient of the limits provided they exist. Okay, so in other words, this is going to equal the limit as x goes to 1 of f of x divided by the limit as x goes to 1 of g of x. But what did we just learn a few problems ago back in part B? Remember that the limit as x goes to 1 of g of x does not exist. So this limit isn't going to exist either because the limit in the denominator doesn't exist. So this is does not exist because limit as x goes to 1 of g of x does not exist. Okay. All right, we've just got a few more here to finish up. All right. Part E. Okay, so this is a little bit different. Here we're going to have to use actually a few limit laws together to figure this one out. So this is a product, right? This is the product of x cubed and f of x. So I'm going to go ahead and split that up. So this is going to be the limit as x goes to 2 of x cubed times the limit as x goes to 2 of f of x. Okay, now let me out to the side remind you of one of the limit laws you just learned. There's a limit law that says the limit as x goes to a of x to the n equals a to the n. Okay, and that's a situation we have here in the first piece, right? We have the limit as x goes to 2 of x cubed. So according to this limit law I wrote in green, this piece is just going to equal 2 cubed. Okay, and now my second piece, the limit as x goes to 2 of f of x. Well, I need to look at my graph. So as x goes to 2, f of x is approaching 2. Okay, so 2 cubed is 8 times 2 equals 16. All right, one more to finish out these. Okay, so once again on this one, I'm going to want to use a combination of limit laws to figure this out. So the first thing I'm going to do is basically bring the limit inside the square root. So if you remember from the limit laws, the limit of a root is the root of the limit. So I can write this as the square root of the limit as x goes to 1 of 3 plus f of x. Okay, now then inside that square root, I'm going to want to use my addition law to break that up even farther. Okay, so this is going to be the square root of the limit as x goes to 1 of 3 plus the limit as x goes to 1 of f of x. Now the limit as x goes to anything of a constant is just that constant. So this first limit is just going to be 3. And then the limit as x goes to 1 of f of x. Well, we found that several times so far, right? And it's just 1. So this is the square root of 4, which equals 2.